folks. All right, video time again, and I wanted to basically go back and talk about the one that I put up last week. But first, I have to apologize. Yes, I sound like crap. I have a cold, and so I got some sinus and some throat stuff going on. My apologies. Anyway, first, regarding the video last week, in case anybody was curious how it was done, I use iMovie to make my videos, and iMovie does have a lot of really cool built-in movies, basically, where you just plug in photos and then it creates this really cool little movie with your photos. This was not one of those. What instead was something homegrown that I did basically in Photoshop. Two of the photos were actually really old Polaroid photos, so that gave me the idea to make them all look like old Polaroids. So I grabbed a stock photo of a Polaroid frame with just black where the photo would normally be, knocked that out so that I just had the white part, and then took all the various photos, scanned them into my computer, because none of these were digital images, these are all old photographs, and scanned them in, cropped them to fit the size of the frame, and plopped the Polaroid frame on top of it so that it kind of had that right shadow effect. And then I grabbed a wood texture for the background. I made the individual photos, the individual JPEGs of the photos inside of the Polaroid frame as their own batch. And then for each of the slides or frames, whatever you want to call them, I took the wood texture, all right, laid the appropriate Polaroid, the new Polaroid, on top of it, and gave it a little bit of a drop shadow effect, especially where there's more than one lane on the other, and then added my text all in Photoshop and just made it as a JPEG. So I have a series of, I think, seven of those for the individual ones, and then the eighth one is the composite of all the photos. To make that one, I just shrunk the photos way down and then laid them all out in chronological order, you know, and added the text on that frame. And then I brought them all into iMovie and use the Ken Burns effect that iMovie gives you, and that gives you the zoom in and zoom out effect. And laid the music down, had to loop it because the music was too short, so I had to loop it a second time. But anyway, that's how I made the movie, in case you were curious. Now, the backstory on each of these photos, that's the more interesting part. So let's start with the first frame that you see. In this one, you're looking at Nofer Blatz from back when we had been married for about 13 months. A little more behind the scenes. I met him when I was in Los Angeles. I was actually living in Florida in this before I went to Los Angeles. And I'd gone out there to do some management training for my job. And met, fell in love, got married, but always with the idea that once I finished this whole training, you know, then I graduated, then I was going to be coming back to Florida. And so when it was time for that, he quit his job, and of course he came back with us. Now, prior to going to LA, I was living, Jennifer and I together, we're living in this, basically a boarding house, if you're familiar with that concept. It was a really large, old house, lots of rooms, and a bunch of people each, you know, rented rooms in this big house. Jennifer and I lucked out, and we had been living in what was probably originally maybe a master bedroom. It was on the downstairs level, and it had a little half bath inside, so it was had a little its own ensuite, basically. And so it was perfect for us. But needless to say, while we were out in LA, they rented that room out to somebody else. So when it was time for us to come back, now here I am with a husband in tow. I had no place to live. So thankfully, they did have two rooms available that were side by side upstairs. So that's what we did. We were crammed into these two rooms, Jennifer in one room and Paul and I in the other. And that's what you're seeing in these two photos, is that room that we were living in, and it was very jam-packed. A couple of feet past the foot of the bed, we had Paul's 8-foot fold-up table. And on that, he had his computer and all of his books. And so that's what you're seeing. The photo on the left, he's sitting there at his desk, so to speak, doing something. I don't remember what he was working on when I snapped that shot. And then the other photo where he's in his bathrobe, that was Christmas morning. And like I said, this is cropped down, so you can't really see everything, but just off frame there is Christmas presents and the little, I guess it was about a 3-foot tall Christmas tree that we had on the tabletop. So we would have our own little Christmas there. So that's what those photos are from. Now, here's the next photo. This one, like I mentioned in the caption, is from my baby brother's wedding. My younger brother is 6 years younger than I am. And I'm probably closest to him out of all my siblings for a variety of reasons. I mean, we are the two youngest in the family, so we were together the longest in the house, you know, when everybody else had moved away and gone to college or whatnot. And so that helped us get really close. Plus, on top of that, we physically live the closest. He's about an hour and a half away from me today. And when I first left my first husband, and Jennifer and I moved to Florida, there was a time period where we lived with my dad and my little brother here in Florida. So very, very close to him. It was a very, very special day to go to his wedding, and I'm happy to report that he and his wife are still very happily married, and they have two little girls of their own. So that's that one. All right, this next one. This was the only surprise party I threw for Paul. It was for his 35th birthday. He was working at the time for a software company. And I behind his back, got hold of one of his co-workers at the office and arranged to coordinate all of this. She got all of the employees to agree to come. So all of his co-workers were going to be there. And we had it at our favorite restaurant, Arigato's. And I can't remember what story I told him where we were going. But, you know, I had to get him to the restaurant, so I gave him some story about where we were going, but then I had him, of course, pull into Arigato, so he kind of knew something was going on, and then he gets inside and wasn't expecting to see everybody he works with there, plus we had a few other people there, too, so it was a lot of fun. This is just him talking to me. That's the menu and, you know, in front of us. I don't know what we were saying, but that's what that is. Okay, now this next one. Like I said in the caption, we didn't expect to get our photo taken, and that's why you see us dressed the way we're dressed. We were finally in a position to buy a new car. I'd been driving this really crappy used car that I had to buy. Long story behind that, I won't go into it. And Noferblatz had his pickup truck that he brought back from California with him. Anyway, we were finally able to trade in my piece of crap used car for a new car, and I had wanted a Saturn for a while. I'd fallen in love with the whole concept behind Saturns and the way they were being sold, and they were affordably priced. So we agreed, you know, we took it for a test drive, fell in love, decided to buy it. Well, when you bought a Saturn, at least back in these days, when you bought it, we didn't realize that there was a whole little celebration. They get the car that you bought, and they bring it out, and they drive it up onto this little podium, and then they bring you two out, and they stand you in front of it, and they take your photograph. So what you see in Noferblatz's hand is the owner's manual to our new Saturn. But we really, really, really were not expecting to have our pictures taken. Anyway, they took the photo, and they mounted it to a calendar, and they gave it to us as, you know, a little freebie. And when that year was up, I saved the photo off of the calendar, so that's why I still had it. So that's the story behind that one. Now the next photo, the Valentine's Day dinner cruise. There's a story behind this one too. On excuse me. On this particular Valentine's Day, I had called our radio station. Did I call them or did I email them? I don't remember now. But anyway, I contacted our radio station and asked them to do a dedication to Paul for Valentine's Day for him to hear during his drive into work. And I told him the time frame that it needed to be so that he would hear it on his drive in. Well, they missed it. They totally forgot and missed it. And it was at the end of the show, their morning show probably went off at, I don't know, 9 or something. It was the end of their show, and they realized that they played a song then for him, but at that point, I doubt he was going to hear it. And the radio station called me and apologized for missing the dedication. And they said, look, we want to make it up to you. We're doing this special Valentine's Day dinner cruise. Would you guys like to have, you know, come on board for, you know, basically give us free tickets for this dinner cruise? And I thought, well, sure, that's cool. So that's what this is from. It was our free Valentine's Day dinner cruise. And we got to meet the DJs, which was really neat because we listened to these particular DJs all the time back in the day. So that's what this is from. When you first walked on board, as you were coming up the gangplank, they were shooting a picture of you. This is one of the two that were actually original Polaroids. You can tell at the bottom there was a big red heart, and so everybody was getting their picture taken as they came on board. So that's the story behind that one. This next one is the other photo that was an actual original Polaroid. I can't remember what this was, but it was probably for my birthday one year. I only could figure out where it went chronologically speaking because I saw some gray in Nofer Blatz's beard. So I knew it had to be after the Valentine's Day cruise one. So anyway, this is at Arigato's, our favorite restaurant. Arigato's is a Japanese steak house where, you know, the kind where they prepare all the food right there at the table. It's really cool. So anyway, when you do a birthday celebration, they include taking a photograph of the birthday girl or boy, and because we're always inseparable, that's both of us there. So I'm guessing that was probably for my birthday. Now here in this next one, you have the two photos. This is back from 2001 when our daughter was pregnant with her first child. So in that lower left photo, that's Jen sitting on my lap. She was very pregnant at the time. Oh God, she looks so young in that picture too. Well, she was. Jennifer was in the Navy during this and was actually stationed up in Georgia, Marietta, outside of Atlanta. But she had come down for a visit, and so this was taken down here in Florida. I think probably at my brother's house, looking at the furniture. And then in the other photo, that of course is after Lexi was born, and Lexi was born right at the end of October, and we finally got to go up to Georgia over the Thanksgiving holiday to finally see our grandbaby. And so there's Jen and Nofer Blatz and me, and Paul's there holding Lexi in his arms. And then the last shot, of course, was all of the photos together in chronological order, all laid out. I wish I had more photos, but you know, that's how it is. Usually one of us is the one behind the camera, so it's rare to get a picture of both of us together. Anyway, now you know the story behind all of the photos. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you, if you're married, I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful marriage that lasts forever and ever and ever. And if you're not married yet, I hope you find that special somebody because, well, what can I say? I'm a big softy. I'm a terrible romantic. So that's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.